Hello friends, my name is Vikas.
So friends, in this video we will be discussing some of the most important current affairs of the first week of November. This video will be very helpful to you, so do watch the video till the end. So friends, we'll start with our session, but before that we have something important to tell you about. So students, we have an app by the name Careers Cloud which you can go and download using the Play Store, and it is available only for the Android users as of now. Once you have downloaded and opened the app, you will see a page such as the second screen here. Then you just need to log in with your Google ID or you can say with your Gmail ID on this application, and once you have logged in, you are ready to use the particular application. As you can see, you will be seeing here My Course, All Courses, Crack Current Affairs. Just click on any of those and you will be directed to a second page. Here now, what are the features or why we recommend you to use the app? Because on the app, we provide you daily current affairs, both in English as well as in Hindi. Both Hindi and English current affairs are provided you daily along with the quiz sessions. This is important. We provide you daily with the quiz sessions that will help you to brush up your current affairs that you gained today through our video or any other notes provided. These English and Hindi PDFs are also provided to you daily. This is provided on our app course that you can go and purchase. Two types of courses are there, 1 year plan and a second year plan, which you can opt as per your need. Then we provide you with weekly videos. Not just weekly videos on YouTube and monthly videos, daily videos are also given. Apart from that, weekly PDFs of current affairs are provided to you. Compiled PDF of current affairs of the whole week will be provided to you, both in English as well as in Hindi. Then similarly for the month also, you will be provided a compiled video of the whole month, both in English as well as in Hindi. PDF for the current affairs that will brush up your current affairs very much. Apart from this, we provide you with the topic wise current affairs, topics such as apps and web portals, important days, books and authors, then comes your sports, then comes your obituary, national affairs, international affairs, sports. These all topics are covered by us on our YouTube channel, which you can go and check it out also. Very important this section, because we provide you with the PDFs also with them that helps you to revise through a particular order, and it is very helpful to you, so you should definitely check it out. Then apart from it, we provide you questions regarding your particular exams also, such as bank related to your banking. We provide you questions, we provide you PDF, we provide you material that will help you to revise those topics, those important topics. So very important. Alright, so I definitely recommend you to check our app and do revise and to purchase the courses, because they will be very helpful to you. These, I strongly recommend you to use our app as well as website, and the quiz provided on the app is very helpful to you on the daily basis, and our monthly study material for your exams will do wonders. So do watch the video for the revision purposes. They are very helpful. And if you use my code VIKAS10, straight away you will be getting an additional 10% discount on the purchase you made using the application. So additional discount for you students, just from my side. It is a happy hour sale, you can say. 10% discount using VIKAS10. So friends, let's start with our session now. So friends, let's start with some national news. Madhya Pradesh has announced Mukhya Mantri Awasiya Bhudhikar Yojana to provide free residential plot to families. India's first manned ocean mission Samudrayan launched at Chennai. Very important, mark this. Next, India's largest landfill biogas plant inaugurated in Hyderabad. Minister of Corporation Amit Shah has launched Dairy Shakar scheme in Gujarat. Daily Shahakar scheme was launched in which state? It was launched in Gujarat. Haryana Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar has launched Uttam Beach Portal. National Tribal Dance Festival held in Raipur, Chhattisgarh. Gujarat launched e-Sarkar app for paperless administration. IOC will set up India's first mega-scale malic anhydride plant in Haryana. RBI panel on ARC's proposed norms for valuers reserve price. Jitendra Singh has dedicated Sardar Patel Leadership Center to the nation. 73rd Information and Public Relation Day is celebrated in Manipur. R.K. Singh inaugurated Pakal Dul Hydro Electric Project in Jammu and Kashmir. Can be asked, where is Pakal Dul Hydro Electric Project situated? It is in Jammu and Kashmir. IREDA has launched whistleblower portal to raise complaint on corruption. Karnataka launched Jana Sevaka scheme and Jana Spandana platform. Can be asked, Jana Sevaka and Jana Spandana platform, the Jana Sevaka scheme and Jana Spandana platform are launched by which state government? Are scheme and portal of which state government? They are of Karnataka. Some international news now. Microsoft surpassed Apple to become the world's most valuable company by market cap. LD gave Huron India Philanthropy list of 2021. It was topped by Wipro's Azim Premji. Prime Minister Narendra Modi participated in the G20 Leaders 16th Summit that was held in which location? It was held in Italy. 2022 QS World University Ranking. QS stands here for Quackerelli Syndrome. World University Ranking. Two Indian institutions among the top 50. National University of Singapore topped this QS World University Ranking. Telangana invited to participate in International Seed Conference by Food and Agriculture Organization. India, Bhutan issued a LOE to add 7 entry-exit trade points. Prime Minister Modi and Boris Johnson launched One Sun, One World, One Grid initiative. This is related to your solar panel. UK has launched a commemorative 5 euro coin celebrating legacy of Mahatma Gandhi. Very important information this. Next, some important days. We have covered the important days in the topic wise video of November. So you can October, you can go and check. These are for November. So we'll be covering them for the November part. So stay tuned for that video. They are just a one liner for revision purposes. 1st of November. On 1st of November, we observe World Vegan Day. I repeat, on 1st of November, we observe World Vegan Day with the theme Vegan for Less. 2nd November, International Day to End Impunity for Crimes Against Journalists. 2nd November is also observed as Ayurveda Day with the theme Ayurveda for Poshan. Mark this. 2nd November, Ayurveda Day. Ayurveda for Poshan is the theme of Ayurveda Day. Next, 5th of November, we observe World Tsunami Awareness Day. 3rd of November, we observe International One Health Day. 6th November, we observe International Day for Preventing the Exploitation of the Environment in War and Armed Conflicts. Then on 7th of November, we observe National Cancer Awareness Day. These were your important days. Now friends, let's start with our important questions, MCQ questions. Question 1. Where was India's first manned ocean mission Samudriyaan launched by the Ministry of Earth Science? I repeat, India's first manned ocean mission Samudriyaan launched by the Ministry of Earth Science. Where was it launched? It was launched in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. Correct option. Important thing is Samudriyaan. We just saw it is the India's first ocean mission launched by which ministry? It will be launched by the Ministry of Earth Science. Next, where was India's largest landfill gas to compressed biogas plants launched by Ramki Enviro Engineers Limited? Where was this launched? It was launched in Hyderabad, Telangana. All right. Next, what is the theme of 14th edition of Urban Mobility India Conference 2021? Theme of the 14th edition of Urban Mobility India Conference 2021. The theme is Mobility for All. Next, identify the bank that recently approved a $250 million loan to support India's National Industrial Corridor Development Program. Which bank gave this loan of amount $250 million? It was your ADB, Asian Development Bank. Where is the headquarter of Asian International Monetary Fund? Washington, D.C. Where is the headquarter of World Bank? Washington, D.C. Where is the headquarter of UNESCO? These are the important ones. Paris, France. Next. Who recently got appointed as the chairperson of the National Company Law Appellate Tribunal? For a period of how many years? For a period of 4 years. So, who has been appointed as the chairperson of National Company Law Appellate Tribunal for a term of 4 years? He is Ashok Bhushan. Next question is, identify the Indian cricketer who was selected for the MCC Awards Honorary Life Membership of the club along with Indian bowler Javagal Srinath. So, who has been appointed? He is Harbhajan Singh. He was a very famous Indian bowler, or you can say spinner. Next, cricketer Alan Keith Davidson, who was the first player to score 100 runs and take 10 wickets in a single test match, passed away. Which country did he represent international cricket? Question asked here is, from which country did he play? He was from Australia. Who authored the book The Nutmeg's Curse, A Parable for a Planet in Crisis? I repeat, who authored the book The Nutmeg's Curse, A Parable for a Planet in Crisis? This book was authored by Amitav Ghosh. Next question. 16-year-old Amy Hunter from Ireland became the youngest player to score an ODI century. Who holds the record for the youngest male cricketer to score an ODI century? Shahid Afridi. I repeat, Shahid Afridi is the set the record for the youngest male batter to score an ODI century, remains with Pakistan's Shahid Afridi. He was 16 years of age when he scored 102 against Sri Lanka. Next, Russian director and actress Yulia Perislid stayed in the International Space Station to shoot the first film shot beyond the Earth. What was the name of the movie for which they stood or they shot in the International Space Station? The name of the movie is The Challenge. Next, name the scheme that was launched by the Ministry of Cooperation during the 75th Foundation Year celebration of Amul. The scheme that was launched was Dairy Sahakar. Very important question. Next, identify the bank that recently signed an MOU with Indian Navy to offer a defense service salary package under Power Salute. I repeat, to provide a defense salary package under Power Salute. Which bank has tied up or signed an MOU with Indian Navy? Name of the bank is being asked to you. So the name of the bank is your Axis Bank. Next, SEBI, Security Exchange Board of India, reconstituted its technical advisory committee consisting of DASH members to recommend improvements in the technological changes under the chairmanship of DASH. So remember, SEBI reconstituted its technical advisory committee consisting of 7 members to recommend improvements in the technological changes under the chairmanship of Deepak B. Pathak. Correct option here becomes option 3. Name the first indigenous P-15B, that is Project 15 Bravo class stealth guided missile destroyer of the Indian Navy, which was developed by Mazagon Dock Shipyard Limited. The name of the indigenous P-15B, that is Project 15 Bravo class stealth missile destroyer of the Indian Navy. What is the name of it? It is, which was developed by Dock Shipyard Limited, that is Mazagon Dock Shipyard Limited. What is the name is being asked here? It is Vishakhapatnam. Next, name the climate action portal that was launched by India during COP26 event. The portal that was launched during the COP26 event was Climate Equity Monitor. Climate Equity Monitor. This can also be read as CME. Alright. Next, One more thing, if we are talking about COP26 event, where did this event took place? This event took place in where? Glasgow. And where is Glasgow, if countries asked? In United Kingdom. What is the full form of COP? We always study COP, COP26, COP25, but what is the full form of COP? COP stands for Conference of Parties. Conference of Parties. All right, next. What was the global theme for 2021's World Cities Day that was annually observed by UN on 31st of October? Theme was Adapting Cities for Climate Resilience. Next. Identify the state or union territory that recently declared Kalij Phesant, also known as Lopburi Leucomeleons, as its state, union territory or bird. I repeat, which state or union territory recently declared Kalij Phesant as the state bird? So, which state recognized this Kali Phesant as their state bird? It is your Jammu and Kashmir. Alright, next. Identify the company that replaced Apple to become the most valuable company as per your market capital. Alright, according to the market capital, the company that replaced Apple was Microsoft. We just saw it in one-liners. Next, where is Indian Oil Corporation planning to set up India's first mega-scale maleic anhydride plant? This is being planned at what location? It is in Panipat, Haryana. Next, who will chair the 20-member empowered group of secretaries that was recently set up to look after the implementation of Prime Minister Gati Shakti program? I repeat, who will chair the 20-member empowered group of secretaries that was recently set up to look after the implementation of Pradhan Mantri Gati Shakti program? It is your cabinet secretary. What is your Gati Shakti program? We made a video on it. Gati Shakti was your to bring all the sectors of a related project under one roof so that the business becomes easy. Or you can say doing business becomes easy. Next. The Defence Acquisition Council, headed by Dash, approved 7,965 crore worth proposal, which includes the purchase of 12 light utility helicopters from which country? So first of all, remember, in November, Defence Acquisition Council, that was headed by whom? It was headed by Rajnath Singh, approved the amount of 7,965 crore rupees worth proposal, which included 12 light utility helicopters that were purchased from Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. Option 3, correct. Next, which bank was selected as the program manager for the 300 million first loss risk instrument, a risk sharing instrument that was launched by World Bank and Niti Aayog to finance e-vehicles, that is your electric vehicles. I repeat, which bank was selected as the program manager for the $300 million first loss risk sharing instrument launched by the World Bank and Niti Aayog to finance e-vehicles? It was your State Bank of India. Next, identify the bank that recently signed an MOU with NCDEX E-Markets Limited to act as a clearing bank for its Argo e-marketplace. I repeat, identify the bank. What is the name of the bank? That is your Bank of Baroda. Recently signed an MOU with NCDEX E-Markets Limited to act as a clearing bank for its Agro e-marketplace. Next. Sathya Ganashekaran and Dash won the men's double title of the World Table Tennis Contender Tunis Tournament of 2021 that was held in Dash location. Where was it held? It was held in, as the name suggests, Tunis. It was held in Tunisia, and Sathya Ganashekaran along with Harmeet Desai won this men's double World Table Tennis Championship that was held in Tunisia. Tamil Nadu government announced to celebrate 18th July as Tamil Nadu Day. When did the central government pass the State Reorganization Act that separated Andhra Pradesh from Tamil Nadu? What was the date it is being asked here? It was 1st of November 1956. Next. Which company signed an MOU with the Ministry of Rural Development to empower local businesses and self-help groups through DNRLM scheme? It was your Flipkart. Next. Which university topped the 2022 QS World University ranking listed by Quakrelli Simons? The university that topped was of Singapore. If you remember from the one-liners, it was your National University of Singapore. Option 2 is correct. Next, which country conducted a two-day long Desert Warrior exercise with the Indian Air Force? Desert Warrior is an exercise that is conducted between India and Egypt. All right. India and Egypt conducted this Desert Warrior. Next, in November, Asian Development Bank approved a $61 million loan for the urban development project benefiting which city? It was for Agartala, Tripura. I repeat, Asian Development Bank approved $61 million loan for the urban development project of Agartala, Tripura. Next, identify the portal that was launched by Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency Limited and PSU under the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy as a part of Vigilance Awareness Week 2021. What is the name of the portal that was a part of Vigilance Awareness Week 2021? It is your whistleblower portal. If anyone is doing corruption, then you can say people can go and contact from this whistleblower portal also. Next, who was the chairperson of the selection committee of National Sport Award 2021? He was Mukundum Sharma. Mukundukum Sharma was the chairperson of the selection committee of the National Sport Award of 2021. Mukundukum Sharma. Next, EVA or Electronic Virtual Assistant is the India's first largest AI power chatbot that was launched by which bank? This chatbot was launched by HDFC Bank. EVA, that is your Electronic Virtual Assistant. Next, which organization developed Ganga Atlas, River of the Past, that was launched during the 5th Ganga Utsav? It was launched by IIT Kanpur. I repeat, IIT Kanpur has developed Ganga Atlas, River of the Past, that was launched during the 5th Ganga Utsav. Ganga Atlas was developed by whom? It was developed by IIT Kanpur. Moving on, read the next question. Which country issued letter of exchange with India to formalize 7 additional entry exit trade points? It was done by which country? It was done by Bhutan and India. Letter of exchange. Who was appointed by the Ministry of Communications to head a technology innovation group on 6G connectivity? As we know, 5G has already came. Now, planning on 6G is also starting. So, who was appointed by the Ministry of Communication that will head a technology innovation group on 6G connectivity? What is the name of the person? He is Raja Raman. Next. The government of United Kingdom launched its first commemorative coin on Mahatma Gandhi, a 5 euro coin. What is the quote used in the coin? The quote is being asked here that what is the quote of the coin that is used in the 5 euro coin that was launched by the government of United Kingdom in the memory of Mahatma Gandhi on Diwali? The quote was, "My life is my message." Very important. Who won the Booker Prize 2021 for the fiction novel The Promise? For the novel The Promise, the person who won the Booker Prize of 2021 is Damon Galgut. Next, where did the Indian Air Force and DRDO conduct 2 successful tests on smart anti-airfield weapon? They were tested in Jaisalmer, Rajasthan. Another important question. Next, Name the world's first earth science satellite that was recently launched by China. From them, as you can say, what is the name of the first world's first earth science satellite that was launched by China? What is the name of the satellite? It is Guangmu. Guangmu 1 is the world's first earth science satellite launched by China. Next, who authored the book The Cinema of Satyajit Ray? The book Cinema of Satyajit Ray was authored by Bhaskar Chattopadhyay ji. Next, when was the first International One Health Day observed? First International World Health Day was observed on 3rd November 2016. Similarly, there are two other days you should know from Indian side. Prakram Divas. And second is your Unity Day. Unity Day is observed for the in the memory of Sardar Vallabhai Patel. Sardar Vallabhai Patel. And it is observed on which day? It is 31st October. Then is your Prakram Divas. When is Prakram Divas Day observed? I am waiting. Tell me. Prakram Divas is observed in the memory of whom, and it is observed on which date? It is also observed on the memory of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, and the day is important, that is 23rd of January. These two are very important days, Prakram Divas on 23rd of January in the memory of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, and Unity Day in the memory of Sardar Vallabhai Patel on 31st of October. Next, then comes some your important field of scientific studies. Study of ant is known as myrmecology. Another important term. Study of ants is your myrmecology. Study of clouds is known as nephology. Study of fish is known as ichthyology. Study of rocks is your petrology. Mark just these four, just for revision purpose. Next. The central government formed the Ministry of Jal Shakti after merging DAS existing ministries. After merging how many industries did the central government form the Ministry of Jal Shakti? So remember, two ministries were merged in this, and the name of the ministries are Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation, and second ministry was your Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitization. Sanitation, not sanitization. Alright. So these two ministries were added, I repeat. Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. And second was Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. Next. Name the hackathon that was organized by Unique Identification Authority of India to exchange innovation among youth. It was your Aadhaar Hackathon. Another important question. Aadhaar Hackathon was organized by UIADAI, that is your Unite Identification Authority of India, to encourage innovation among youths. If question is asked here that which ministry organized it, that can also be asked. It was organized under the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. Next. Which country collaborated with India to launch world's first green grids initiative, that is One Sun, One World, One Grid program. I repeat, the One Sun, One World, One Grid program was launched by India along with which country? It was along with United Kingdom. Next. Which organization adopted first of its kind resolution to protect schools and civilians during armed conflict? It was done by United Nations Security Council, that is your UNSC. Adopted a first of its kind resolution to protect schools and civilians during armed conflicts. Next, DASH was declared as the world of the year for 2021 by the Oxford English Dictionary. What is the word of the year 2021 declared by Oxford English Dictionary? So what is the word? The word is vax. Vax has been chosen as the word of the year 2021 by the Oxford English Dictionary. Vax, which in turn refers to vaccine or vaccination, repeatedly appeared in the news due to, as you can say, COVID-19 or pandemic going on. So Vax is related to vaccine or vaccination, and it has been the word of the year for the year 2021 by Oxford English Dictionary. University of Technology Sydney, along with private companies in Australia and Canada, are planning to send a rover to Dash for searching water. The mission will be launched in Dash year. So, University of Technology Sydney, along with private companies in Australia and Canada, are planning to send a rover to Moon for searching water. This mission will be launched in the year 2024. In November 2021, Dronacharya awardee Tarak Sinha passed away. He was awarded for his contribution towards which sport? Dronacharya award was given to him, or question is indirectly asking that Tarak Sinha, who was a Dronacharya awardee, is related to which sport? He is related to cricket, and he was also known as Ustad Ji. So friends, this was our video. I hope you enjoyed it. Vikas signing off. So friends, this was our video. I hope you enjoyed our video. If you liked our video, do hit the like button, share the link with your friends. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel, or if you are new to our channel, then do subscribe, because it motivates us to bring a better content for you guys. Also, if you have any trouble regarding login or payment or any other issues, then you can reach to us on our mail, that is support@affairscloud.com, or you can call us on the number 9677333862, and we'll resolve your issue as soon as possible. Also, you should go and check our courses that are available at a very reasonable price, and that will help you to boost your preparation.